This video is part 2 in a series of videos on graphing in Excel 2010. Part 1 in this series was an introduction to pie charts and bar graphs. In this part, I will step you through the process of making one of the pie charts I used in part 1. On my Excel spreadsheet, I have the information for the in-state student tuition and fees. To start a pie chart, there are two main ways. The first is to select your range of data, go to Insert, Pie, and choose one of the options here. I'm going to choose this 2D pie chart option. It's the simplest one and it'll represent our data very well. As you can see, it already fills in the size of the slices according to the numerical values of our tuition and fees. Another way to start a pie chart is if you don't have a range of cells selected, you can still go to Insert, Pie, and make your selection, and it'll just fill in an empty chart. It tries to guess what your range will be, but as you can see here, it is wrong. So what you can do, instead of deleting this and starting over, is you can right-click and go to Select Data, and this is your data entry. I'm going to edit this and change the series name from what it automatically selected as pie charts to the in-state, tuition, and fees. Then the series values, instead of these two cells here that it selected, I'm going to delete that and reselect this range of cells here. As you can see, it automatically filled in the pie chart the way it had been previously, but the legend is still incorrect. So if I select OK, the place I go to change the legend is here, the horizontal axes. So I go to Edit, and the range of cells for the axes labels, or in our case, just the legend, is right here, because each of these corresponds to the price value associated with it. If I select OK and OK again, you can see that the legend has been filled in. However, there are only 6 options on the legend, and that only goes to about here on our list. This is an easy fix. All you have to do is make your graph larger. But since this graph is so large, I'm going to go ahead and just move it to its own sheet. So if you right-click and go to Move Chart, I'm going to choose the new sheet and label it In-State Pie Chart. And it moves it to a new sheet that's directly before the sheet that has its price information. Now, as you can see here, the pie chart is very large, but all of the text is rather small. Before I change the size of the text, I want to label the pie chart slices. I'm going to expand the ribbon up here and go to Chart Tools and Layout. Data Labels, these are the options to change the data labels on the slices themselves. For the labels Center, Inside End, and Outside End, you have the same problem with all three of them. It'll show up well for the three larger slices, but once you get to the smaller slices, the numbers all run in together. So instead, I'm going to select Best Fit. This is where the computer tries to decide where is the best place to put all of the data labels to make it easier to read. I'm going to move the title over here to give a little more room for the data labels. But since they're so difficult to read, I'm going to change their font size. So by clicking on one of them, it automatically selects all of them. And I can right-click and change the font size to 14. As you can see, the numbers are now much easier to read. I'm going to go ahead and do that and change the legend also to font 14 and change the title to font 20. Now here, it still has some overlap between the slices. So what I'm going to do is move a few of these manually to see if I can get them to arrange themselves in a way that they're easy to read. There. It's not perfect, but you can still tell which slice everything corresponds to. Also, if you select one of these, since these three here that are on the slices have a dark background and dark text, if I go ahead and select just one, I can right-click and change the text color, and I'm going to change it to white. And now these are much easier to read. I can go through and do this for each of them. I do not, however, want to change these to white since it's on a white background. There are other different design options you can do. If you go to Design tab, you can choose different color schemes. You can have 3D or black background. Some of these are very visually appealing. However, if you're going to print it out, keep in mind that it may not print the exact same way it shows up on the screen. And also, if you choose one with a black background, you're going to use a lot of ink when you're printing. I'm going to go ahead and leave this in the same design that it automatically did. Now, just by looking at this pie chart, you can see that there is a lot of information available. The number on the pie chart slice corresponds to its matching comparison value. For example, this blue slice corresponds to tuition, which is $12,650. If I hover over the slice, however, some more information is available. For example, here I can see that the series is in-state tuition and fees, The point is tuition, which is also the comparison value. The value is $12,650, which is visible on the slice itself. But what's the extra information is the fact that it takes up 45% of what is paid for this student. So an in-state student pays only 45% of their total fees and tuition as tuition alone.